Welcome back, guys, to another video. Let's talk about BlackRock. Once again, it's always super interesting to see what they are purchasing. And when BlackRock purchases stock in massive bulks, you know something's up, and you know that company is most likely going up because BlackRock, they have a lot of people, more than 13,000 employees in 30 different countries, and they do a phenomenal job. They have a really good risk management team, and they do really well. They're by far, in my opinion, one of the best investment firms out there. A lot of people who have millions of dollars give their money to BlackRock to help them invest. And guess what? If you check out BlackRock's stock on Robinhood, it's been going up, up, and up, and outperforming the S&P 500, which half the fund managers on Wall Street can't even do. Now, BlackRock so far, they have a lot of money. I mean, more than $7 trillion in assets is definitely a big thing to brag about. And before we dive any deeper into what they're purchasing, definitely check out the free Discord server, link in the description below. There's more than 17,000 members, and it's completely free. It's one of the most active, one of the biggest stock option Discord servers on the Discord platform, and it's free. So why not check it out? Definitely click on it. It's one of the best perks. So let's check out what BlackRock is purchasing. Long story short, they're purchasing a ton of Uber shares. If you check out this quarter's filings, they increased their Uber position by 42%. It almost feels like BlackRock loves Uber so much that they're willing to spend millions and millions of dollars more. They increased their Uber position by 18 million shares. That's insane. And they have a total of 60 million shares. And currently, the amount of money to have an Uber stock is roughly $2.2 billion. That is a ton of money. And so far, they're increasing their positions more and more on the overall company. And no joke, they seem to like it a lot. And the crazy thing is, they actually invested in Uber not really that long ago. It was last year, quarter two. And ever since then, they've been increasing positions. But only recently, especially this quarter's filings, turned out that they actually bought the most Uber stock. Let's just see why BlackRock is so interested in Uber. And it's not just BlackRock. A lot of other companies are really interested in this ride-hailing company. If you check out the overall stock, of course, it's not really performing that well in the very beginning, but recently Uber has been spiking up a ton. It's one of those stocks that we just don't really talk about, but in the past month, it's up 43%. In the past 3 months, it's up 61%. But of course, it's only recently when the share prices were actually going up. And of course, Uber took a really massive plummet during the overall pandemic, going down to as low as $21. And now it's at $48, nearly doubling from the all-time lows. I mean, seriously, congratulations to Uber because they're doing some pretty incredible stuff. And they currently have a market cap of $86 billion and they're rising more and more. There's a few things about Uber because they have somewhat changed their business model. They changed it to be more effective in this really wacky market. If you check out what they're doing, they have a lot of different things. When Uber first started out, it was simply ride hailing. It wasn't super appealing until recently. They started adding more and more stuff to it, almost making Uber more of a tech company than a transportation company. You can see you could get Uber Eats, pretty much discover all the delicious things you could buy. It's kind of like Grubhub, but they also have rides, which is still the main core of their business. On top of that, you could actually earn stuff. Either if you're a customer, you could actually earn points and use the points to redeem for really cool rewards, or it could be a driver and ride for Uber. And you also have Freight, which is also pretty unique as well. You know, they have different businesses. They also have Transit, Bike and Scoot, and also Elevate. I guess they have drones. This is pretty crazy as well, but this is mostly a concept, but I could kind of see Uber Air pretty much taking off because currently, for example, in my city, Lexington, there's no direct flights from Lexington to Louisville. You have to drive, which takes 2.5 hours, probably 2 hours, but if you use Uber Air, it only takes about 30 to 45 minutes. So it's a lot faster. It pretty much caters to locations that planes don't actually cover because it's not profitable. So yeah, Uber is actually doing a lot of stuff. If they actually even manage to do this, it's gonna be a really techie company. It's gonna be more of like an aviation AI software company than anything else. So this is why the valuation is going up. Obviously though, Uber isn't like the best money-making company, but honestly, everyone's just betting on the future prospects of this ride sharing app. And it's now more than just a ride sharing app. It has a lot of other stuff. Like they got flights, They got like Ride, they got Uber Eats, they got Business Transit, Bike and Scoot. There's a lot of different things in the overall company. On top of that, Uber is also expanding their rewards program, which makes customers more loyal to Uber, because since Uber and Lyft are pretty big competitors against one another, Uber and Lyft, people aren't really loyal to whichever. But if you have a bunch of Uber rewards, and let's say you're only like a few points off from getting like a 4 months free of Apple Music, you're probably gonna be using Uber for today just to get enough points. So this point system will actually keep a lot of people attractive into the overall stock and also the overall app. And so far, this is pretty nice. You can clearly see like the program offers like 30 plus rewards from like 100 points to 8,000 points. Every dollar you spend on Uber is 1 point, and it goes to like 2 points, 3 points, depending on which tier of rides. If you get like the luxury SUVs, it's like 2 to 3 points per dollar spent. And you can also use like 500 points for 4 months of free Apple Music. It's not like that cool of a thing, but it's actually like a pretty decent perk. I mean, if you use ride sharing apps for a really long time, you probably have been fluctuating between Lyft and Uber. But now with this point system, consumers will much rather use Uber more often just so they can actually get, for example, 4 months free of Apple Music or like 30 days free of HBO Max, for example. So it's actually a pretty unique strategy to keep the consumers loyal to the app. On top of that, you do have Tesla talking about self-driving capabilities, robo-taxis, and Elon Musk even said that the company is talking to a lot of other major corporations and say how future robo-taxi systems will allow an Uber or Lyft driver to manage a bunch of different cars. It's pretty insane because autonomous driving is a major deal. And once again, Uber is pretty innovative. They're even doing like drones and also major delivery systems. And they're definitely on board with the autonomous driving on the road. Imagine seeing a whole fleet of Uber robo-taxis, maybe even created by Tesla. On top of that, the amount of users using Uber has been increasing by a ton. And so far in the third quarter of 2020, 78 million people used the Uber app on a monthly basis. And that's a 42% increase compared to Q2 of 2020. This is pretty awesome. And this is massive growth. And just this growth and more users using the Uber app and also new innovative things made the share price actually surge up. And this is why BlackRock increased their positions, because they started noticing, okay, Uber seems to be more of a techie company more than anything else. Unlike other ride-hail companies around the world, they're becoming more software-driven, more AI-driven, and also instead of just focusing on ride-hail, they're also focusing on other branches. Very similar to how Tesla is more than just a car manufacturer, they focus on other aspects like autopilot, battery production, and solar panels, which is pretty nice as well. Last but not least is the annual revenue. For 2017 to 2018 to 2019, revenue has been increasing. Now, obviously, though, the increases have been kind of stagnating, but still, double-digit percentage growth is something that you could definitely brag about. They're making more money. You can clearly see annual revenue for 2017 was roughly $8 billion. 2019 was $14 billion, and this year it should be even more. Now, a lot of different stuff are coming in, especially how like the Uber Eats is making them a lot of money. Just this specific section of Uber makes them a lot of cash. They also have Bike and Scoot, which is also pretty important, I guess. They got like the spin, what is this, like jump bike? Jump, I guess, I don't know. It's probably like those electric scooters I see all over in campus in my university. They're pretty fun and they're pretty popular. And you also, especially this thing where you could actually get points. This is actually keeping Uber users more loyal to the overall software. I feel like BlackRock knows what they're doing. They probably calculated this pretty perfectly. And this is a massive increase in the overall position. I mean, we're adding in 18 million more shares of Uber. That is a pretty big position. Usually, BlackRock doesn't really add that much money to one specific company. They usually do it like slowly. But of course, a 42% increase in Uber is a pretty drastic amount. And I feel like BlackRock knows what they're doing. They feel like this company could be going to the moon in the next couple years, especially how Uber is focusing so heavily on aviation, other branches other than ride hail. And I feel like their leadership is pretty good, especially how they're also focusing heavily on autonomous driving. So they're becoming more techie than ever before. Thanks for watching, guys, and comment below. Definitely check out the free Discord server. You don't want to be the guy that misses out. It's completely free, unlike other Discord servers out there. So definitely join in and have some fun. Thanks for watching.